With growing concerns over the coronavirus, health is the top of mind for many around the world, and the total number of confirmed coronavirus cases globally now topping 45,000, and the death toll surpassing 1,100. And while the majority of those cases are in China, as we've reported before, residents here in Hawaii want to understand the virus and stay healthy. So joining me now, we have community physician Dr. James Ireland. Thank you for joining us.
Good evening.
He is here to talk to us about staying healthy amid not just coronavirus concerns, but we are also in the midst of flu season. But first, going back to the coronavirus, people hear the death toll, they get really worried. Tell us, doctor, who is most at risk?
Well, the data coming from China shows that people with pre-existing health conditions seem to be at the most at risk, and also the folks who are a little older. So older than 50 or 60 years old and with conditions such as diabetes, heart problems, or breathing problems.
How is diabetes related to this coronavirus, and what do you mean by underlying conditions?
Well, underlying conditions mean other health problems that people already have, and diabetes and high sugar seems to impair the body's ability to fight infections. The white blood cells, the natural killer cells, just don't work as well when the sugars are higher. And so we've known for a long time that unfortunately people who get flu or influenza can have a higher death rate if they have diabetes. And this seems to be the case for coronavirus as well.
Oh, interesting. Okay. So if someone does contract the virus, what will that look like in terms of their sickness and their symptoms?
Well, what we're seeing from China is the mild cases, people may have a fever, chills, body aches, much like the flu, a cough. But the more severe cases, it can develop into a pneumonia, shortness of breath, trouble breathing. And those are the folks, unfortunately, that are being put in the hospital and some are dying.
Okay, now let's talk about the flu. Something doctors here say is a much greater risk and or much greater threat to Americans. So for you, doctor, how has it been? How has flu season been?
Well, it's busy, and I saw patients this week with the flu. The hospitals have flu patients in them, and so we're still encouraging people to get their flu shots. Of course, wash your hands. Don't come to work if you're sick. Basic hygiene stuff. But many more Americans and even people in Hawaii are dying of the flu every year. And this is potentially preventable with some hygiene and flu vaccination measures. Mm-hmm.
So we've had some chillier weather than what we're used to and wet weather. Does weather play a factor at all as far as getting sick or spreading a cold or an illness?
Well, we definitely know flu is seasonal. October, November, December is kind of when flu starts. And in the early winter months is when it's kind of in peak season, usually. There's some different theories on that. One theory is maybe that the flu particles or infectious particles survive longer in colder weather. That's possible. Maybe people are more gathered, not necessarily in Hawaii, but in the mainland, they're gathered in smaller places or indoors because it's cold outside. And so groups of people are closer together and can transmit things easier. But a lot of that's just theories. But flu is definitely seasonal, and we do see it in the colder months.
Okay, so let's talk about how people can stay healthy, because you were saying diabetes is a factor as far as weakening your immune system. How do we strengthen our immune system?
Well, I think just overall health, good amount of sleep, eating properly, staying hydrated. And if you do have diabetes, keeping your sugar, working with your doctor to keep your sugar under the best control you can, will allow your white blood cells and immune system to work the best that it can under the circumstances. There's a lot of research on supplements, but there's just so little data so far that, these immune boosting supplements, they make your wallet thinner. But as far as how it can help your health, a lot of the jury's still out, so to speak.
You were saying as far as diabetes goes, you can take tomorrow as a step in the right direction.
Absolutely. So, eating better, more exercise, weight loss, and working with your doctor to optimize your medications if necessary can all be measures and ways to lower blood sugar to allow your immune system to fight off these things like influenza and the various ailments that we catch just in ordinary life, going about our business, so.
So that's the trick. Stay healthy, eat right, exercise, get lots of sleep, right, Doc?
Yep, and I'll add too that the health department has put on their website, the Department of Health, a coronavirus section where people want to learn more about that, they can click on that and learn just some kind of the hygiene things that Dr. Park and the health department's recommending.
Awesome, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
Some important tips and information. Bridget, send it back to you.
All good to know. Dr. Ireland, Lauren, thank you.